C4 and Brian Neiman.
Expect more from WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.
Oh, I am excited, I must say. I'm not nervous, but I am excited about the game. Laura Newman, who's sitting in today for Brian Neiman on this Friday. Laura Newman, former Anne Arundel County executive. Where the Baltimore Ravens are at home against the Cincinnati Bengals, primetime game, Sunday Night Football. But I remember last year when the Ravens were when the Ravens had a lead going into the third quarter, and next thing you know, the Cincinnati Bengals are moving the ball up and down and feel like Patton going through Third Army, going through Europe. So maybe to talk me into a good place, Jamison Hensley joins us right now, ESPN.com reporter for the Baltimore Ravens, WBAL radio contributor. As we get ready, we're a lot healthier going into this game than we were last year, J-Mo.
Yeah, especially in the secondary. Last year when Joe Burrow set like Bengals records throwing against the Ravens, they didn't have Marlon Humphrey. They didn't have Marcus Peters. Now they have a first-round pick in Kyle Hamilton. They have Marcus Williams back there. But I thought it was interesting this week when Marlon Humphrey said, he's sitting eating lunch in the team cafeteria and he looks up at TV and he sees Ravens 32nd ranked pass defense. And Marlon said, you know what? That's not only humbling, but it's unacceptable with the talent they have in that secondary. And I have a feeling just talking to guys this week, they have a lot of respect for the Bengals wide receivers. You have Jamar Chase and T. Higgins and Tyler Boyd. But I think they have a feeling or I think they are hoping that this is a great opportunity on national television to show everybody that this defense isn't as bad as a lot of these rankings and a lot of the end of games recently have been for them.
Well, J-Mo, isn't it about pride at a certain point? I mean, going back to last year, this stat blew me away, you know, listening to some of the ESPN folks talking. The Baltimore Ravens have given up more points in the fourth quarter than any team in the NFL going back to last year. And so, in other words, you know, at a certain point, doesn't pride step in? You say, we have a lead. We're going to protect this lead.
Yeah, and it just seems like, C4, looking back at this Ravens defense, when you've had Ray Lewis, Ed Reed, Terrell Suggs, it seems like over the past 20 years, they've had somebody on that defense that when the game is on the line, that can come up and make a play, or if not make a play, that guys on that defense can look to in these clutch situations and they go, okay, we're going to be okay, you know, because we have this guy on defense. I don't know if they have that person right now on this defense. I mean, you're hoping that it could be a Marlon Humphrey.
Right.
You're hoping that a Dafe Owe or a young guy like Patrick Queen can do something like that. But that's been the biggest problem at the end of games is that they have just not had a guy step up and make that crucial stop. It seems like these quarterbacks are having too much time in the pocket to throw. And then at other times when there has been a little bit of pressure, there's been a wide receiver that's been running free because of miscommunication. It just seems like there's always one mistake on these late game plays that have just been crushing this team.
Jamison Hensley's on board with us. Once again, the Baltimore Ravens play the Cincinnati Bengals this weekend. Well, one thing, though, regardless of the two, we really could be 4-0, the two losses where we had double-digit leads that we lost, is the play of Lamar Jackson. I mean, you know, one of the things that people are excited about is he growing now after four games into that quarterback that we thought he could, reading defenses, you know, picking people apart, that type of thing, J-Mo?
Yeah, and I mean, when we talk to, or, you know, I see a lot what other teams are talking about Lamar, the week of preparation, and you see, you know, Patriots players, Jets players, and this past week Bengals players talking about how they have seen an improved Lamar Jackson out there. And, yeah, I mean, Lamar still can run the ball. He ranks ninth in the NFL in rushing. He has more rushing yards than, you know, Derrick Henry, Joe Mixon, a lot of top running backs. He still has, but I think where he has really, really improved is throwing the ball. And he's not, when he goes back and drops back to pass, if somebody's not open, you know, he's not taking off and trampling. He is waiting for guys to get open. And a lot of times, when they're not open or don't have a lot of separation, he's throwing to areas where they can get open. And I think that's been kind of the biggest step forward for Lamar. And I think some people had some hesitation because he didn't go to a lot of the voluntary off-season workouts.
And, like my co-host?
They were,
like my co-host.
All I want to say is, Jameson, thank you for being here today. Because, first of all, I'm impressed at how long people can talk, take talking about sports. Like, literally, you could, like, spend the whole day talking about sports. And I know C4 can, so thank you for being here today, because otherwise I'd be in big trouble.
But Brian Niemann definitely had some issues with the off-season lack of workout of Lamar. He did.
Yeah, and I think we've seen so far. Look, you kind of Lawrence said back then. He's like, you know what? When it's ready to play, I'm going to be ready to play. And that's what Lamar Jackson does out there. And it's without. And I think right now, Rashad Bateman, their top wide receiver, you know, he hasn't practiced the past 2 days.
I want to talk about that.
Yeah, and so there's a lot of injuries on this offensive side. I do think they might get Ronnie Stanley back. But still, you look at the supporting cast around Lamar Jackson, and it just makes those numbers that he's done so far even more impressive.
So with Rashad Bateman dinged, let's just say dinged, and we don't know exactly how much he'll play, James Prochet, Isaiah Likely, do we step up and see more of their involvement in the offense, J-Mo?
Yeah. I mean, for on the outside, Devin Duvernay now, you know, if Bateman, who suffered a foot injury, if he can't go, Devin Duvernay is now the number one wide receiver. The number two is DeMarcus Robinson. Mm-hmm. Isaiah Likely, I think that's a name to watch, because I think he has been a little quiet, or quieter than I think a lot of people thought over the past four games. I think now when there's going to have to be somebody with, when you lose Rashad Bateman, there's targets that go to him every single game. There's going to be somebody that's going to get more of more action than previously over the past four games. I think if you're asking me, I think Isaiah Likely would be a guy that gets a little bit more attention this week because you don't have a Rashad Bateman.
All right, Jameson Hens, let's talk about some Palace intrigue if we can, because a lot of people, and Coach John Harbaugh said it's not a problem, a lot of people, is there any residual effect from the blow-up between Marcus Peters and Coach Harbaugh at the end of the at the end of the game? Marcus Peters really isn't talking, at least media reports, to a lot of the media.
Yeah, because when I went up to him and I asked him, Marcus, do you have time for us? This is in the locker room on Wednesday. He says, I don't have nothing for you all, and then he walked away. But, yeah, I mean, when you watch that in a game, and it's an emotional game, but you don't see that very often. A lot of times if there is conflict or a little people upset each other, they try to keep it in-house. But, I mean, you watch that sideline, and Marcus Peters have to be pulled away from John Harbaugh, yelling, screaming. It was not a great scene for the Baltimore Ravens. But this whole week, you know, I've asked guys about it. They said, you know what, this happens a lot. You just don't usually see it on television out in front of everybody where all fans can see it, media can see it. They said, you know, they addressed it as a team this past week. They've talked about it. You know, John Harbaugh said, you know what, Marcus Peters is one of his favorite players, and he hopes that he's going to be one of his best friends going forward. So it seems like everything they've moved past it. But still, this is something to monitor. If things happen and you know, things get a little more difficult or they have more bumps in the road, we'll have to see how players and John Harbaugh react, because right now that is a talking point. That is something we have to monitor going forward.
Now, the weather should be very nice Sunday. It's not too warm, but very nice. And last week, of course, the rain with Buffalo restricted a lot of different things. J.K. Dobbins, integrating him more into the offense. Do you see that, J-Mo? And particularly, you know, he looked pretty good last week.
Yeah, early on in the game, he has. But I think in the second half, where we saw, and they talked about they want to ride kind of the hot hand. And I thought Justice Hill was the more explosive back. And now, again, I keep talking about injuries. He suffered hamstring injury. Yep. He is not playing this week. So I think a lot more will fall on.
But didn't Coach Harbaugh say it wasn't that bad of a hamstring? He actually said it's not as bad as what it might have been.
Yeah, because if it was bad, he would be out for the season. That's how bad it could have been. Mm-hmm. So I think he's going to be out there with these hamstring injuries. You have to basically just say sit and wait, and hopefully it'll heal. But he's definitely not going to play this week. So you look at J.K. Dobbins, Mike Davis. I mean, those are going to be the guys that are going to have to step up. But that's been a big problem with the Ravens outside Lamar Jackson. Mm-hmm. They just have had no explosive plays from the running backs. And so, I mean, this is a team that for when they've had Lamar Jackson as a starting quarterback, 60%, they've pretty much run the ball 60% of the time. But this year, it's kind of done the reverse on him. Because of the lack of a running game, Lamar Jackson has thrown the ball 60% of the time on this offense. So we're seeing a little bit more of an identity change right now, and I think it's something that they would prefer to run the ball still a lot more. It's just because they're not getting that production. They've had to make that shift in philosophy right now.
Finally, J-Mo, when it comes to, we signed A.J. Klein off of the taxi squad from another team, Giants, I think it was. We got him on board as a linebacker. One of the complaints, at least what we're hearing, is that the coaches aren't that thrilled with the linebacker play. What do you think?
Yeah, I mean, when you see Patrick Queen had such a great first game, and then the past three games, he's just taking bad angles. Mm-hmm. He's making missed tackles. Josh Bynes, and believe me, Bynes has done so much for this team.
He hustles.
Undrafted, and then has played in this league for over a decade. But still, I think right now you're kind of seeing he just doesn't have that same speed as he once had. So I think they need to do so. They need to address something in the middle of that defense, just because you see, especially in the passing game and against tight ends, they're getting just wide open. And going forward, they need to have, I think, a little bit more depth on the inside. I think, you know, right now it's still Josh Bynes and Patrick Queen in the middle of that defense. Mm-hmm. But still, if they continue to struggle, they just have to look elsewhere, because I think that is one of the bigger problems they have on this defense.
Well, I'm going to take all the notes that we just talked about, and Laura Newman and I are going to figure out a game plan.
Thank you, J-Mo, for being here today.
As we work on a game plan in the commercial break. Jameson Hensley, ESPN.com reporter for the Baltimore Ravens, as well as WBAL radio contributor. Always great to speak with you, man. Take it easy, okay?
Okay. T4 and Laura, you have a great rest of your show.
You
Thank you.
I appreciate it. Laura and I will talk sports right during the break. Stay tuned.